My name is Charlotte, and I'm a resource management officer.
My name is Siobhan, and I am a resource management technician.
We work in Guayanas, a national park reserve,
National Marine Conservation Area Reserve,
and a Haida Heritage Site. Guayanas is co-managed with the Haida Nation.
This week we're working with the European Green Crab Research Team from the Council of the Haida Nation.
So Jen, what are we looking for?
We're looking for European green crab, which are invasive to Haida Gwaii. They're really bad for the environment because they often destroy eelgrass habitat, and what they tend to do is snip the eelgrass and burrow into the mud banks underneath, causing like instability in the eelgrass bank. This is bad because eelgrass is like a nursery for a lot of our native species like Pacific herring and salmon and octopus and many other species. They also outcompete our native shore crabs and juvenile dungeness, so they're pretty harmful for our environment.
And yesterday we got some bad news. Previously we had not found any green crabs in Guayanas, but yesterday we found some in Echo Bay, so that's really sad to find. And then another devastating thing is one of the bears got one of our traps.
A little crushed.
But hopefully just in that one location we find them, and so we could mitigate their impacts. Fingers crossed.
So this is a hairy shore crab. He's got hairy legs, and he's one of the good guys, native to Haida Gwaii. Actually, it looks like we caught a green crab, which is really sad. This is the first green crab that we've caught here in Slim Inlet, here in Guayanas. So yeah, as you can see on either side of its eyes, it has 5 points. But if you look at the shape of the carapace, they're quite different. Shore crabs are often like square or rectangular, whereas the green crab has more of this pentagonal shape.
Nope. Flipped it. So Jen, now that we've found green crabs, what is the next thing that needs to happen?
We're going to be recording the size and the sex of the green crab, and then we're going to remove it from the marine environment.